Welcome to Bhakti Sangha Japa Conference Call. Today we are very fortunate to have His Grace Sri Guru Gauranga Prabhuji to enlighten us on Srimad Bhagavatam. So thank you so much, Prabhuji, for giving your valuable association and time. Now I would like to hand over the call to you, Prabhuji. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji, for giving me the opportunity and the service by which I can engage myself and progress in Krishna consciousness. Thank you, everyone. Am I audible properly, Mataji?
Yes, Prabhuji, yes, very clear.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Chapter 22, text number 56. So before starting, we'll just glorify Srimad Bhagavatam. Shunnatam swakatha krishna punna shravana kirtana hridantastahi abhadrani vidhunoti suhridsatam nastaprayesu abhadresu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishtaki. So today's shloka is 4:22:56. Rajeti adhan namedhyam soma raja iba paraha suryabat visrijan grinan pratapamscha bhuvo vasu. Translation: Maharaj Prithu became as celebrated a king as Soma Raja, the king of the moon. He was also powerful and exacting, just like the sun god, who distributes heat and light and at the same time exact all the planetary waters. Purport: In this verse, Maharaj Prithu is compared to the kings of the moon and sun. The king of the moon and the king of the sun serve as examples of how the Lord desires the universe to be ruled. The sun distributes heat and light and at the same time exacts water from all planets. The moon is very pleasing at night, and when one becomes fatigued after a day's labor in the sun, he can enjoy the moonshine. Like the sun god, Prithu Maharaj distributed his heat and light to give protection to his kingdom, for without heat and light, no one can exist. Similarly, Prithu Maharaj exacted taxes and gave such strong orders to the citizens and government that no one had the power to disobey him. On the other hand, he pleased everyone just like the moonshine. Both the sun and moon have particular influences by which they maintain order of the universe. The modern scientists and philosophers should become familiar with the Supreme Lord's perfect plan for universal maintenance. Om Ajnana Nirandhasya Jnananjana Chalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Sa Padantikam Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Juta Padakamalam Shri Guran Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunathan Dhitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sagana Lolita Shri Vishakhan Dhitam Sa He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Brinda Baneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Deve Pranamami Hari Priye Banchakalpa Taruvascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaye Vacha Putitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnamebhyo Namo Namaha. नमो विष्णुपादा कृष्णपृष्ठा भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामीन इति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशोतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते गोपाल कृष्ण गोस्वामी इति नामिने प्रभुपादस्य साहित्यं प्रकाशयति गुरु सर्वशरणं गतवान् सर्वोपदाय नमः. So first of all, I would again thank all the devotees in Bhakti Sangha Japo group for giving me the opportunity and engaging me in the devotional service of the Lord. And by everyone's blessings, I would like to speak about this topic and whatever I learned from Srila Prabhupada's teaching and from the association of the devotees. So I would like to share that. So this verse is the continuation and the glorification of Maharaj Prithu. And we see that Maharaj Prithu is a great king as well as a great saint simultaneously. And this is always expected from ideal system, ideal society basically. And in contrast with the Prithu Maharaj kingdom, we can see today's society, and we can clearly understand the differences. And in the Vedic society means there is Varnashrama society, and where there are like four divisions we know. And of course, like we learn about the Daivi Varnashrama system, which is the much more perfect system and which slowly help everyone to achieve the ultimate goal of life while engaging everyone's nature, whatever nature they have, everyone has, they can engage in the activities in that nature and simultaneously slowly progress in the Krishna consciousness. And that happens when everyone engage in their occupational duties, and the fruit of the occupational duty they engage in the service of Lord and service of the Vaishnavas. And we can see that Prithu Maharaj gave the great example of this Daivi Varnashrama system. So here two things are there. One is the king understand the real purpose of life, and he has the practical understanding how to execute it. And simultaneously, not only the king, but also the king has a lot of brahmanas. King is guided by a lot of brahmanas who are perfect in understanding about the ultimate goal of life. So that is the kingdom of King Prithu Maharaj. And as we see that in the later ages also, there were a lot of kings like that, like Bharat Maharaj, before that Rishabhadev, and also in the later time we see Yudhishthir Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj, so like that. Even in the like present day context, we see that during Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time, the king of Odisha. So like that, we have many such examples that it is actually practically possible in this world that there could be a king who is as saintly as Prithu Maharaj, and who will be guided always by Brahmanas and Vaishnavas in particular. So this is the ideal system, and when it happens, then we see that today's verse we read that how glorious Prithu Maharaj, and the analogy is given with king of Somoraj, the king of the moon, we know that how important duty the king of the moon and king of the sun god has, and they play such an important role on behalf of Supreme Lord. So Supreme Lord actually says that actually they are just like the eyes of the Supreme Lord. So when we see the sun and moon, we should we can remember the lotus eyes of the Supreme Lord. So here the importance of simultaneously Prithu Maharaj's glory is presented, as well as the importance of sun god and moon god is also given, how they are duty bound in this material world to help all the living entities to execute their duties and slowly understand the real purpose of life. So we can understand that this material world, there are two worlds, spiritual world and material world. And it is explained that that this material world is by nature, it is dark. And in darkness, there is no actually activities. And by Supreme Lord, by Krishna's causeless mercy, so he provided the sun and moon to actually to such that we can actually perform our desired activities. And slowly we understand our actually ultimate goal of life and perfect ourselves. And in particular, like in this, from this pastime, so what all points we learn, this chapter is slowly ending, and we learn many of the important points from the chapter. One is definitely as we discussed that the varnashrama system is so important in the society to practice, actually even to practice Krishna consciousness, it is aiding basically. Of course, like pure devotional service doesn't depend on any of the material circumstances, but for the practitioner, for the preaching of Krishna consciousness, if we have this varnashrama system, it is much easier. And otherwise, like, there is a chaos in the society. So currently, for example, we see that our society, like, it is like headless. And we can understand with an analogy that if a person is there and if the person don't have a head, so how like awkward and chaotic the situation would be. So this is pretty much today's society, where there is no clear actually varnashrama system. And in India, Srila Prabhupada mentions that in India, actually some form, of course it is not the clear form, it is already extremely deviated from the original Daivi Varnashrama system, but the some form is there, and with time actually it is very fast deteriorating. And like I can give part, like practical example, like I am from like one of the rural part of India, and when we were like in our school life, we used to read that about 70% population of India is actually the farmers. And at least in my time, I have seen that our previous generation, all the elderly people, they were engaged in their duties. Of course, that is not spiritual activity, but they were engaged in actually their Vaishya activities. And then in the later part, like in our generation, I have seen that nobody had any interest in farming or cultivation, and everybody was interested and determined to go to city and enter in the factory and do this industrial job. And and everybody thought that that is the actually the goal of life. And we can understand that how this this actually destroying whole system. And currently in our also in our different classes, we hear that how important is to have proper diet simple living, high thinking life. And one of the point comes again and again about the diet. And that time actually I can connect that when the varnashrama system is destroyed, then there is no actually proper voices to cultivate the agricultural to do the agricultural duties, cow protection, and of course the other part is that the trade, the business part, Kshatriya's duties like krishi, goroksha and banijya part is there, like transport is going on like today's day and age in large scale, but the base part, which is like krishi, agriculture and cow protection, these two part are like largely affected. And what is the result of that? And many of the part of the world, we see that commercial agriculture, that means that capitalist people will take up the land and with large scale they will try to produce the grains. And what will be difficulty of that? Difficulty of that is that one thing is that people will lose job, and second thing is that big machines will do their job, and all kinds of artificial means of cultivation by which like the inorganic or the inorganic fertilizers and all those chemicals will be used, and we can see the effect of that. So much like cancer and so many new diseases are coming every now and then. So there is disease like more and more the medical system is improving. In the one side they are trying to improve, and another side more and more disease is also coming up. So this is clearly because of the result of the destruction of the proper varnashrama system. And if the proper varnashrama system, in particularly if daivi varnashrama system, where the fruit of the everyone's occupational duty is not engaged in the service of Lord, then this kind of actually situation will arise. One side, people will be working very hard to earn their livelihood and maintain the standard of living, and one side like medical cost and all those things, and another side the food quality. It's like Srila Prabhupada mentions that ugra karma, like one side we are working hard, which is not necessary, and another side lot of newer diseases are coming up. That is also in natural course, which would not which may not have come. So this is the reason. And Krishna also told in Bhagavad Gita that Chaturvarna Maya system, so which is clear that this varnashrama system is not like human creation. It is actually Lord has created in the beginning itself, from the beginning of the Satya Yuga, and so that like people can be really be happy and simultaneously prosperous, and simultaneously they can actually slowly progress in the ultimate goal of life, which is to understand that we are part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, and this material world is a place of like it's a foreign place basically, Dukkhalayam Asashvatam, and our original place is the spiritual world. And and many other teachings like we can find in this pastime, which is like continuation of the glory of Prithu Maharaj, that when the monarchy or the head of the state understand the real purpose of life, he simultaneously understand that all the people in this material world, the natural tendency is sense gratification, and he knows like how, and he consult actually with the Brahmanas and Vaishnavas that how people can be slowly elevated to the higher purpose of life. And that way he creates actually certain situations and certain facilities. And we can see like with the examples at the present day and age, how can we implement those teachings in our practical life. And we can see how our previous acharyas, they acted in similar fashion, that those who are able to understand Krishna consciousness, for them they have given the pure devotional service. Those who are not able to understand, for them they created a facility by which they can work and they can make their livelihood. And also those who are not at all able to understand or anything, do anything, for them they have created a facility for by which mass distribution of prasadam, and we have Gurukul school where anybody and everybody can have the access to actually send their anybody, devotees also can send, or also ordinary people also, they can send their child and slowly they can progress like that. Many things they have created, and they in particularly they wanted us to act in that way, that we understand the essence of pure devotional service, that ultimately the Supreme Lord is the proprietor of everything and he is the controller. Isavasam idam sarvam, we understand that that Supreme Lord Krishna is the proprietor of everything and he is the controller, and everything should be engaged in his service. And by that way actually we can be really peaceful in this material world, and finally we can be able to go back to spiritual world and back to Godhead. And and for us in particular, what to take, in the previous classes also we have seen that devotees have mentioned that majority of our population is like grihasthas in the household life, and how we can take example of Prithu Maharaj and the previous acharyas example and practice this Krishna consciousness is simply by in particular the morning time. Srila Prabhupada mentions in certain places the importance of the morning time, that it is from the Bhagavad Gita chapter 2 text 19, where Srila Prabhupada in the purport very clearly state that the utilization of morning time towards the end of the purport. And he says that in the morning, early morning, a devotee should get up early in the morning, take bath, enter the temple and offer prayers and chant Hare Krishna mantra, and then offer flowers to the deity, cook for deities, and read Srimad Bhagavatam and hear Srimad Bhagavatam. That is practically our morning program, Srila Prabhupada mentions. So for Vihastas, this is very, very important, that we put our best effort, and wherever we are, we spend the morning, early morning hour time in chanting the Hare Krishna mantra and worshipping the deities and reading and hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, and some service cooking for the deities. And that way actually we can actually perfect our life. And naturally in the daytime we have certain duties to perform, we do that. And we try all the fruit of our activity, whatever basic necessity we have in our family life, and then we use everything in the service and propagating the Krishna consciousness movement. And that is the thing Srila Prabhupada and previous acharyas always wanted from us. And if we live, Srila Prabhupada in particular, in the present day and age, he lived actually in that example. And we see that he spent a significant amount of time in the Vyasta Ashram, about more than 20 years or about 20 years. So in that ashram, Srila Prabhupada has shown how like we can practically spend actually our time in Krishna consciousness in properly. So he set an example by regularly chanting 64 rounds, because that time actually the rule was to chant minimum 64 rounds. And some of the Srila Prabhupada's biography writing, when we read, we hear that how regularly Srila Prabhupada was determined to chant 64 rounds, although he had a lot of household duties, children, and the need of like family and his work, everything he maintained. And simultaneously, he was always faithful to his spiritual master Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and always meditated on the service of his spiritual master. And regularly, like, he chanted 64 rounds of japa, and then whatever in his in the Grihastha Ashrama, he contributed and supported the Gaudiya Math preaching mission. And that way, actually, he developed the mood of actually topmost renunciation. Although he spent time in the Grihastha Ashrama, but he led a life like a topmost renunciate. And how we can understand that he spent time like a topmost renunciate? Because when he took the Sannyasa Ashram, he was so stable and so firmly fixed in his determination. And if he didn't have the determination, we can understand this single-handedly doing this great task was not possible. So he was extremely determined. And that determination is not overnight, that he took sannyasa and then that great determination came. No. Because his early life in Grihastha Ashram, how he spent, that is very important. And he persistently and consistently devoted in practicing basically Krishna consciousness and serving his guru, serving his spiritual master and the devotees in regular basis. And that way actually one can develop the mood of highest devotion. So highest level of devotional service can be achieved in that way. That is the very practical example for us. Otherwise, like many times, like things could be theoretical. For example, like Prithu Maharaja's example, like at the present moment, we don't have the king Prithu Maharaj, and neither in overnight we can expect such king. Of course, it is expected that that slowly, slowly our Krishna consciousness movement. This is the beginning of Krishna consciousness movement, where it came to Western country all over the world. And before this, it was only confined in the subcontinent India. And that too, like after Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates have, close associates have departed, after that also, it was very much limited, very, very limited to very, very, like almost unknown to the common people about the pure teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, until again in the later time Bhaktivinoda Thakur and then Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur in particular, like he spread this movement throughout India very vigorously when India was facing a great trouble and everyone was looking for material prosperity, modernizing everything, making it like a Western country. So in that time actually Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur preached Krishna consciousness in India, and then later Srila Prabhupada brought it to the whole world, and slowly we got in touch with Krishna consciousness movement. And the practical thing is like Srila Prabhupada has set an example. And by his following his footsteps, we can see that this Krishna consciousness movement, at least many of the part of the country is expanding, like very widely. We can think like in India, in Russia, and some part of the like other countries really expanding very well. And of course, like after departure of Srila Prabhupada, like in especially like the Europe and America, there were some difficulty, temporary difficulty, which devotees explain and says that actually when a great acharya leaves, and there will be immediate vacuum, and then slowly his teaching and his example will be come into picture. It happens like in the past also it happened, and then slowly it's like devotional service is like a ocean wave. Some of the Vaishnava literature I have seen that it is described also like this, that eastern wave, western wave, northern wave, like that way, that way. So because this is material world, and there will be influence of the especially the Kali Yuga effect, the age of quarrel and hypocrisy. But simultaneously, the pure desire of the Vaishnavas are also will come into picture, and then the devotional service again take its position, and the fortunate souls will take the advantage of this glorious practice. And in particular, like at the today's day and age, it's not today's day and age, it's every time, like devotional service is very important and essential. Without it, like there will be no good quality. So this is also another practical thing to take, that Prithu Maharaj and his kingdom had all good qualities, because everything was at least under his guidance was engaged in the service of Supreme Lord and in the worship of Supreme Lord. And similarly, if we engage our time, resources and everything, whatever we have, in the service of the Krishna and Vaishnavas, then actually all the good qualities will come into picture. Otherwise, in the other hand, in different parts of the scripture, it is mentioned that if someone have apparently lot of good qualities but doesn't engage in the service of the Supreme Lord, then those are actually not good qualities, because the point is that those are first of all is very temporary, and they ultimately will not appreciate and acknowledge the mercy and the empowerment of Krishna and the Vaishnavas. Today, like whatever we are, like whatever I am speaking and whatever we are in, it is actually the empowerment of the Vaishnava Association. We don't have anything, at least I don't have anything. And I can remember like how like sinful life I had before coming to Krishna consciousness. Although we born in very rural part of India, but nonetheless, like in the rural part, we may think that life could be comparatively like more clean, but it is not like pure. Unless someone takes to Krishna consciousness, there is no hope in the lowest of the like region of the hellish planet, nor in the highest planet of the Brahmaloka, because everywhere there will be problem, there will be issues. So unless we take the Krishna consciousness very seriously, all the apparent good qualities will go in time, and ultimate and at the end, based on our past pious deeds, we may do some good activities, and we'll try to take all the credits, pretty much like people in this material world, whatever they do, and they try to claim everything, that they are doing everything, and in return they want name, fame, and then at the end we see that many cases like they do very heinous act, very sinful act, and then everything spoiled. Of course, one thing is that they get a very quick name and fame in the society, and probably that is their past deeds. And this material world is very, very much in flux. Very much in flux means it's very fast. Like they get the name and fame very quick, and those things goes also in very short time. And in Krishna consciousness, whatever comes, it is permanent. All the happiness and all the good things come. It might be many times it is slightly slow, but it is everlasting. So that way actually we can understand that the importance of practicing Krishna consciousness and the practical aspects of at least in our Grihastha Ashrama, how we can implement Krishna consciousness. And we can take example in particular from Srila Prabhupada, how he led a life with a persistent, like a constant practice and mood of surrender to his spiritual master, and following the principles and the process given by the previous acharya, then we can develop the mood. And the name and fame is actually the byproduct of practicing devotional service, and this should not be at any way like our aspiration. And Srila Prabhupada, we have seen the example, his life, that he was never after like name and fame. When someone practiced like spiritual life, at least like in other societies, we see that the name and fame part is the very subtle part, which is very difficult to give up. And that is the one of the major driving force to do this good activities. And also in like any other activities in this material world, in the beginning people may have the desire for wealth and security and all those things, but in the later time we have seen that name and fame is actually very subtle, and it remains actually. And devotees, our Vaishnava association and the scripture always warn that how we should be free from all kinds of false designation, because this name and fame, everything, whatever, they are actually particularly designated to this particular body. When we give up this body and we don't know that name, fame, what happens, it definitely it's not carried forward to the other life. So the best way is to follow the footstep of the previous acharya. Our process is to become the dasanudas of the gopis. Gopi bharto pada kamaleo, that shloka says that our real identity is that we are the servant of the servant of the servant, like that way, like the of the gopis, the topmost devotees of the of Lord Krishna. And especially like in Bhakti Sangha Japa Group conference call I am joining recently, and I am really getting the advantage of in the morning chanting with the devotees. It's really amazing, because many time in this part of the world we don't have regular access to the temple, and in the family life how we can survive and progress in our Krishna consciousness. So this technology, whatever modern technologies are there, these are more of a towards the destruction of the world. But the devotees know how to use it for the constructive purpose and use it for the ultimate goal of life. So devotees that way engage this technology in such procedure like this Japa conference call. And I would really thank all the Matajis and Prabhujis who are in the conference call, specifically those who are leading the call, every day in the early morning, and with so sincerity, like every day, some places it is 4:30 and some places it is 5:30 a.m. To the class time, class end time, and then also in the noon time there is another class. So I really appreciate and really thank for engaging me in this service, and pray for our progress in Krishna consciousness, for our devotion, such that our devotion to the lotus feet of our spiritual master, to the assembled Vaishnavas, and to the Lord Krishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our devotion arises. So with this, I would like to end my sharing of Prithu Maharaj's pastime. If anyone has any comment or question or any realization, kindly share. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for the invitation. Yeah. Actually, this call is only possible if the speakers like you are here. So thank you so much, Prabhuji, for giving us your valuable instructions, like how to develop the mood of the servant, of the servant, of serving. So we thank you so much, Prabhuji, for giving your association. So I will request devotees, if they have any questions or comments for Prabhuji, then they can ask now. Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji, for engaging me in service.
Very nice class, thank you. Very nicely you explained everything.
Thank you. Thank you, Mataji, for appreciating, and thank you for joining. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Please come again.
Thank you. I am there, Mataji, regularly joining. Maybe not active.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandavat.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam.
This is Damodaranand Das from Bloomington, Illinois. Prabhuji, thank you very much for your time and such valuable information. I have one question. You know, we always use this term, Varnashram system, and then we qualify with Daivi Varnashram system. So what's the difference between these two?
Prabhuji, what I understand is that in the Varnashrama system, definitely there are four classes, like the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. The one thing is that in the ordinary Varnashrama system, they engage in their occupational duties, but they ultimately don't, their fruit, whatever fruit they are, that is not actually engaged in the service of the Lord. And in the Daivi Varnashrama system, which like you will see some of the ISKCON communities, they are trying to develop that. For example, like in anywhere, like in our side, we have New Vrindavan, and you will be seeing like many new people are hired in the job for, like, for example, like cow protection and agriculture, and they engage their like mood. So they are not interested in Krishna consciousness. They are interested, let's say, to do some job and earn something and have like proper meal. So they engage in that way, their occupational duty, cultivation of cows and agriculture. And naturally, they partake in taking prasadam, and they sometime. So in that way, they slowly connect with the devotees and in the devotional service, and they become devotee. And when they become devotee, they don't give up also their duties completely. They do the same activity, but they become devotee. But in the beginning, you can see that their intention was just to like occupy their engage in their occupational duty. But the product of that is that later they become full-time devotee actually. So in ISKCON also, many devotees, like I know Keshavananda Prabhu also, he has one community. But these are like small scale, very small scale. And in the beginning, the head of the society has to be a devotee. That is one of the condition. Because if the head is not a devotee, then how can you, like, fruits will be engaged in Krishna service? The head will use all the fruit, like, let's say, all the taxes, and engage in the sense gratification. That is happening like this capitalist society. So, for example, like, you take the example of Walmart and this Amazon or whatever, Apple, like, people engage in the activities, but the fruit ultimately engages in the sense gratification, because the head is not the devotee. So there has to be significant number of devotees in the community, at least the head and the driving people. So in Prithu Maharaj's example, the head is Prithu Maharaj is a devotee, pure devotee of Lord, and we see his father, when he was cursed to death, the Brahmanas, in that example, we see that they were the perfect Brahmanas, not the caste Brahmanas, who understand and praise the Vaishnavas and appreciate also the Varnashrama system. So, if head is Vaishnava, the guided people are also Vaishnavas or at least in the Brahminical platform, then people will be slowly engaged in their occupational duty and they will become devotee. That is my understanding, Prabhuji. Thank you for asking, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you very much. Very nice explanation. And as it is, we see, even if we don't have the Sanatana Dharma, the society does fall into these four categories of Varnas. You know, we have workers, we have intellectuals, and we have, you know, the ruling people. So that's actually the natural division of the society, even if they don't have the knowledge of Vedic system. But you're right, when the society is in Krishna consciousness, then it becomes Devic, and everybody has opportunity to be liberated. So that's very important. And Srila Prabhupada mentioned that in Kali Yuga, most of us are Shudras, because we are in jobs. So we are in the service category of Shudras.
Actually, Prabhuji, one point to add, we are fortunate that we are able to come under the shelter of this practice of devotional service and Srila Prabhupada's teaching. Whatever capacity we have, we are trying to understand Srila Prabhupada's teaching and Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam with the empowerment of the Vaishnavas. But in the large scale, as you also mentioned, this importance of Varnashrama, in large scale preaching require actually to establish this Varnashrama, because common people will not be able to take directly Krishna consciousness. And in practical, like, you can see like how much like it is not easy. And therefore, if people are engaged in their occupational duty and the fruit is engaged in the service of Lord, and if there are temples and there are good devotee association, they will slowly become devotees, you know. Yeah. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you so much for the very, very nice class and for the wonderful discussion. Thanks for your time and thanks for coming on the call. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj, for your encouragement. Thank you for your association. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you so very much for the class and for reminding us of the very important basics of Krishna consciousness. Because sometimes I feel myself that I get so wrapped up in the philosophy and kind of wanting to know more and getting engaged in more that way that I sometimes forget how valuable the very basics of Krishna consciousness are. So thank you so much for that reminder. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji, for your kind words. And whatever I spoke and whatever I have, it is the empowerment of the Vaishnavas. I have, you know, we don't have anything.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, if no one has any questions or comments for Prabhuji now, we can end the call.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, very beautiful class. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji, for engaging me in the service. Okay, we can end, Mataji, by chanting.
Okay. So, thank you so much, Prabhuji. Thank you so much all for joining. Then we can end here. Vancham, Kartar, Vishka, Kripas, Indikrishna, Patita, Naam, Bhav, Nidhyo, Vaishnava, Vaishnava, Namonama, Anand, Koti, Vaishnava, Niki, Jai, Srila, Prabhupada, Ki, Jai, Srimad, Bhagavatam, Ki, Jai, Hidre, Shri Guru, Gauranga, Prabhu, Ki, Jai.
All the Ashram, Ki, Jai, Srila, Prabhupada.